Hi friends, welcome back to HTL Lectures. This is Hadid Mustafa. Let us continue with CMA Foundation Economics Lecture. This is our last chapter in CMA Foundation. The name of the chapter is Money Market. In this chapter, we have two things: meaning of market and structure and function of Indian money market. These two points will be discussed in this video. Okay, so let us start. See, we have already studied about a chapter, market. In that, we have discussed about the market where we exchange goods and services. In this chapter, we are talking about the market, but here the goods or service is nothing but money. In this market, only money is traded. Money is traded for money. So that is the difference with the normal chapter of market and the money market. So let us go in detail what are the things we are going to study in this. What money market do? Money market mobilize savings from different sources. See, mobilize means makes movement. What they mobilize? They mobilize the savings of a people of different sources and makes them available for investment. See, same like banks. Bank is also doing the same thing. They are mobilizing, they are collecting the savings and giving it as an investment or loan to the businessman or government. That is the activity of bank. But this is not just the activity of bank, but there is also money market which is involved in these activities. Whenever you need money, you can approach the money market. Whenever you have the savings, you can go and invest in the money market also. Okay, so that's it. Now let us go to the meaning. In the meaning, the financial markets are functionally classified into. So here we can see a word, financial market. Financial market is classified into money market and capital market. Money market is a chapter that we are going to discuss. Capital market is nothing, but it is also known as stock market. Stock. Okay. Stock market. So this stock market, this capital market, we are not discussing in this chapter. We are discussing the money market now. Okay. So let us see the meaning of money market. Money market refers to institutional arrangement which deals with short term. This is very important. Here in the money market, we are dealing with short term funds. Money market is not for long term investors or long term savings group, but it's for short term purpose. Very short period, like 1 day, 7 days, 15 days, 1 month. And what is capital market? Capital market, on the other hand, deals in long term funds. Capital market, like stock market and all, they were dealing with the long term investments. Okay, now let us go to the definition of money market. Crowther, what Crowther says about the money market, let us see. Money market is a collective name given to the various firms and institutions that deal with various grades of near money. This is very important. See, this money market is dealing with near money. What is near money? Those item which is not a money, but this can be used in place where you need money, where you can use it, like treasury bills, commercial papers, all this comes under this. They are near monies. So whatever transaction, whatever the things that we are dealing in the money market is also known as near money. Now the definition of RBI, Reserve Bank of India, has given the definition of money market. What this is: sender for dealing, mainly for a short-term character. See that we have already said in monetary assets. It meets the short-term requirements of borrowers and provides liquidity of asset to the lenders. It is short term. It is short term requirements. Okay, that is what we are dealing in the money market. Next one is objectives of money market. Objectives. There are three objectives explained in the money market. First one is ironing out short term surplus and deficit. See, if you have a short term surplus with you, you can invest in the money market. You have more money which you can invest for short term, then it is better to invest in the money market. And if you need a short term fund, that you need the fund for only 2 days, 5 days, 15 days, then you can go for money market. So the objective is to iron out short term surpluses and deficit. Then focal point for the intervention of central bank for influencing liquidity in the economy. See, these money market instruments are used as an liquidity controller of the central bank. Central bank uses this money market operation as a controller of liquidity. If you need more fund into the economy, what they do that the RBI or central bank sometimes purchase something from the money market, so that fund will flow from the RBI or central government to the money market and more funds will be coming to the market if you want to increase the liquidity. And if you don't want to increase the liquidity, then they will do the opposite. Okay, so this is an activity that is done by the central bank. Next one is access to users of short-term money to meet their requirement at a reasonable price. That's it. Use the short-term money to requirement of reasonable price. See, the money market, in the money market you get the instrument in a cheaper price than other market. Okay, thing is characteristics of money market. In the characteristics of money market, what we do is that first point, short-term funds are borrowed and lent. We know that short-term funds, this is always repeating point, short-term fund. And next one is no fixed place for contact of operation. See, in case of capital market, you can say that there is a market like stock market, like Bombay Stock Exchange, National Stock Exchange, Kolkata Stock Exchange, whatever. So this market is a place of business. But in case of money market, there is no such place. There is no fixed place that you can go there and buy some money instruments. No, there is no such place from where you can buy this money market instrument. So how they work? The transactions are conducted even over the phone. So even over the phones also you can do this transaction. Okay, there is no place available for transacting. You can do it through phone, online, or any other ways that is available, but not in a place. Okay, then third point, with or without the help of brokers. In the money market also there are brokers, capital market also there is brokers. So here also you can deal it with the brokers. Without brokers also you can transact. Then next one is close substitute for money. See, instead of giving money, you can just give the instrument of money market. Okay, like promissory note, checks and all that we use in a normal terms, in that place also you can give the money market instruments. Loaned for a maximum period of 1 year. That's what I said. You can give for, it's a short term period. So it's maybe 1 day, 7 days, 15 days, 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year maximum. 1 year you can give. Next one is large number of submarkets. There are many submarkets available. Okay. Functions of money market. What are the functions of money market? We have already discussed two things in money market. That is objective. Then second one is characteristics. Third one with that we are going to know is functions of money market. What is the function? Let us see. It is purely market for short-term fund or financial asset. See, the short-term is there in all the three headings: objective, characteristics and functions. Okay, so it's a very important point. Next one is working capital requirements of industry, trade and agriculture. So it is a working capital requirement. What is working capital requirements? Short-term requirements. These short-term requirements are only dealt with in the money market. So working capital requirements are usually dealt. High degree of liquidity is there. The money market instruments have high degree of liquidity. You can transact it very easily within few days. Okay, like call money, treasury bill, commercial bills, all this comes under money market. Okay, these are the instruments, some few examples of the instruments. Okay, next one is it helps trade and commerce by developing a bill market and acceptance market. Hey, you can see that bill market or acceptance market also, there you can get the bills exchanged with the money. Okay, all this is possible. That is also function of money market. Next one is enables the government to raise short-term loans with treasury bill market. Short-term loans with treasury bill market. That's it. So it is all about the short-term loans. Okay. After this points, we'll be discussing the call money and treasury bills, commercial bills. Okay. So that's why I'm not discussing about it now. Controlled and regulated by RBI. This is very important. RBI is the authority who is dealing with the money. So RBI is controlling this activity. Then monetary policy effective. It makes monetary policy effective. What is monetary policy? See, in India, we are actually giving two types of policy. One is fiscal policy and other is monetary policy. Fiscal policy is generally given by the government, central government. They will be giving all the policies that government is going to do in the next years. That way, sometimes we do it in the budget or other meetings and all this. But whatever the money related transaction, that is dealt in the monetary policy, and this monetary policy issued by the RBI. So RBI's policy, we can say, it makes the RBI to give many money market instruments to control the monetary policy, or to give effective monetary policy, they will use this money market also. Then next one is opportunities for lending the surplus fund of individuals. That is, if you have surplus fund, you can give individuals, banks and other institutions, it's an opportunity for them to lend this fund, this surplus fund. The central bank in maintaining stability of the value of currency unit. Central bank will interact in this market. They will sell and purchase. We have already said that in order to maintain the liquidity, and there is also other purpose, in order to make the currency value stable, they will be interacting in this money market. Now, structure of Indian money market. Structure of Indian money market. See, Indian money market have two sectors, that is organized and unorganized. In the organized sector, we have Reserve Bank of India, commercial banks, saving banks, non-banking companies, cooperative banks. Okay, all this comes under organized sector. That means the money market is done through an organized sector or through an unorganized sector. Organized sector means Reserve Bank of India, commercial banks, savings bank, non-banking companies, cooperative bank. Okay, here the commercial bank is further divided into scheduled commercial bank and non-scheduled commercial bank. What is a scheduled commercial bank? See, those companies which is mentioned in second schedule of RBI Act is known as scheduled commercial bank. Those which are not mentioned in those second schedule is known as non-scheduled banks. So what are the scheduled banks? They are further classified as public sector banks and Indian banks. Public sector banks have state bank group and nationalized banks. Okay, so these are the money market sectors. There are two sectors, organized and unorganized. Organized have no other further classifications, but we will discuss in detail what are these things, organized and unorganized now. Okay, so let us move to organized sector. See, why we call this as organized sector? It is called organized because its activities are systematically coordinated by RBI. That means whatever organization or activity coordinated by RBI is known as organized sector. Okay, there is a control, that's it. Now, organized sector, organized modern sector of Indian money market comprises, what are they? This we have already discussed. Now, Reserve Bank, State Bank of India, that is SBI and its associate banks, Indian joint stock commercial banks, scheduled and non-scheduled. Okay, of which 27 scheduled banks have been nationalized. So some scheduled banks are 27 scheduled banks have been nationalized in India. And the exchange banks, that Exim banks and all this, cooperative bank, special insurance, special institutions, and these things, these institutions, all this comes under organized sector. Okay, now there's one more, that is non-bank financial institution, that we have already discussed the financial institution in the financial institution chapter. We have already discussed about the LIC, GIC, a general insurance company and its subsidiaries, UTI, Unit Trust of India, all this we have already discussed. These are the non-banking financial institution. Through this also we can do the money market operations. Okay, next one is quasi-government. Quasi-government is something which is not completely the government organization, but there are some private owned, or there is some rules which are governed by the central government. Okay, that's it. Then next one is cooperative credit institution. occupy the intermediary position between the organized and unorganized position of Indian money market. There is a three cooperative credit institutions. Cooperative credit institution means cooperative banks. See, cooperative banks have three tier structure. One is like state level, that means at the top. At the top, there is a state cooperative bank. State cooperative bank is there. And the lower level, there is a primary credit society and urban cooperative bank. You can see that urban cooperative bank, service cooperative bank, all this comes under the local level. And there is one more, that is a middle level. Middle level is nothing but district cooperative banks. Okay. Any state and government cooperative bank should be included in the organized sector. The organized sector. Okay. The cooperative societies at the local level are only loosely linked with it. See, we have already said that organized and unorganized. Organized means what? Those coordinated by RBI. The cooperative bank is also coordinated by RBI, but it is not 100% regulated by RBI. There are many state-wise or district-wise rules and regulations incorporated. So there is limitations for RBI to involve in these operations. Okay. So that's why we cannot say that cooperative banks are 100% organized, but to an extent we can say that. That is why this paragraph is incorporated. Only state and central cooperative bank should be included in the organized sector. State and central cooperative banks are organized 100% with the regulation of RBI, but there are cooperative societies of the local level, like several urban cooperative banks, credit societies, all this will not be governed 100% by the RBI. So this is loosely linked, not completely linked, loosely linked with it. So we cannot say that it's unorganized, but it is not also the organized. It is loosely linked. There is some changes. That is why we here we use the word intermediary position between organized and unorganized. Okay. So that's it. Now, unorganized sector. What is an unorganized sector? It is unorganized because activities of its parts are not systematically coordinated by RBI. Whatever organization which is not coordinated by RBI is known as unorganized sector. Constitution of money supply. Now the organized and unorganized sector is over. Now we are going for the constitutions of money market. First two parties, who are the lenders and borrowers. Money market operates with the two parties, that is lender and borrower. Lender means someone who gives money to the money market, and borrower is something who take out the money from the money market. So what do they do? The main constitution of the money markets are lenders who supply and the borrower who demands. Okay, this two person constitutes a money market. Next one is supply of fund. Short-term funds in the Indian money market. Two main sources of money supply. See, there are two main sources of money supply in the money market. Okay. First one is through organized sector. We have already discussed this point. Supply of money is through two sector. That is, one is from unorganized and other is organized modern sector. Okay. Now, demand for funds. Demand for funds. Who demands? The main borrower. Who are the main borrowers? The central government, state government, local bodies like municipalities, village, panchayat, etc., and others like traders, institutions, industries, all this comes. Okay. General public is also involved. So everyone can demand from the money market. There is no restriction that you cannot go out. There is, everyone can involve in this money market. Okay. Now there are many sub markets in organized money market. See, this sub market we have used somewhere else in this chapter. Let us check. See, in the characteristics of money market, we have used the last point as large number of sub markets are there in the money market. So we are going to discuss about this money market. Okay. Indian money market can be further classified into following sub markets. What are they? Call money and notice money, commercial bills, treasury bills, commercial papers, certificate of deposit, interbank participation certificate, collateral loan market. We are going to discuss all these instruments in detail. The first money market instrument that we are discussing is call and notice money market. Call money represents the amount borrowed by the commercial banks, that is it, by commercial banks from each other. That means it's a money market instrument used for banking sector. Banks will be buying from other banks. Okay. There are no other parties involved in this transaction, okay, from each other for short period to meet their cash reserve requirements. Okay, whenever banks needs funds, they will ask the other banks to get some fund. Okay, these banks whose cash reserve declined below the statutory requirement borrow from such banks which have surplus cash reserves. So the banks which have surplus fund can give the fund to the such banks who have no fund or reserve fund adequate with them. Okay, funds are thus borrowed and lent for one day and for a period up to 14 days. Okay, so it is generally for one day to 14 days that we give the loan, loan called money, without any collateral securities. No collateral securities are required. Without any security, they will give this fund. Okay, trust. Okay, that's it. Two segments are there: call or overnight market and short notice market. See, what is that means? Call or overnight market means whenever they need a fund, they will ask it at a call or overnight. They will be asking the fund, and the party who have given the fund, they can also return it at any time. And in the same way, there is also short notice market, where that whenever the banks ask and return their fund, then they should give a short notice to the bank who have borrowed. Okay, so this is the two ways. Either you can call or you can give a notice. There are two ways of call money market. Okay, the rate at which the funds are borrowed and bent in this market is called as call money rate. Okay, it's easy. The rate is determined by demand and supply. It's market determined by the demand and supply of the instrument. Okay, so this is the first instrument, called and notice money market. The second money market instrument is commercial bill. Okay, see, commercial bill is nothing but the bill of exchange that we have already studied in the accounts. You might have learned commercial bills, bill of exchange, bills receivable, bills payable, all this. So this is a commercial bill market. These are bills of exchange drawn by the seller. Seller draws on the buyer, the drawee and acceptor, for the value of goods sold. See, this is nothing but what we have studied in the accounts. Okay, when once the bill is accepted by the buyer of the good, that is drawee, it becomes a legal document. See, it will become a legal document once it is accepted. Okay, acknowledging indebtedness, that says, he says that I have to pay you this much amount after this this much days. So maybe for 30 days, 45 days, 60 days, whatever. Okay, so in that case, when the seller will draw a bill to the buyer and the buyer will accept it, he will sign and send it back to the seller and he will keep it until it is paid. Okay, when the payment is received, he will return this bill of exchange, or he will strike off or tear off this bill of exchange. That is the that's the strategy. Okay, bill of exchange. Now it is a negotiable instrument. Okay, such bills are drawn generally for 90 days. Generally the bills of exchange are drawn for 90 days. Okay, during the tenure of the bill, if the holder is in need of cash, he can discount it with the commercial banks. The holder, the seller who is holding the bill, the seller will be holding the seller. If he need fund before these 90 days or before the turnover, before the ending of this turnover, he can go to the commercial bank and he get it discounted. That's how it works. The bank will deduct interest called the negotiated discount rate for the period the bill is yet to run. That means the bank will not give the full amount. If the bill is for 1 lakh rupees, bank gives only something like 95,000 or 98,000, whatever, based on the bank's rate. Okay, this is how it works. The remaining amount will be the profit of the bank. The bank will receive the face value on the due date from the drawee. On the date of receipt of the fund, that is on the date of 19th day or the last day on which the bill is maturing, that day the bank will ask the drawee to pay the bill, and they will take the full amount. Bank will take the full amount, face value. Whatever the difference will make the profit for the bank. If the bank is in need of fund, see, I'm a seller, I've given it to the bank and the bank will keep it up to the maturity. But sometimes the bank also needs some fund, so they can further rediscount this to other banks or somebody else. Okay, that's it we are saying here. If the bank is in need of fund, it can rediscount it in the commercial bill rediscount market. This is a commercial bill rediscount market at the market related discount rate. Okay, The bank arrange their bill portion in such a manner that some bills mature every day. These trade bills are considered liquid asset as they can be converted into cash quickly by rediscounting. That's it. It's a liquid fund. It is not it is not very hard to sell the bill. They can sell at any time they want by rediscounting in the commercial bill market. Okay, this is how it works. Then next one is treasury bill. Okay, what is treasury bill? Treasury bills are short-term promissory note issued by GOI. GOI means Government of India, at discount, generally for a period of 91 days. They are issued to meet short-term financial needs of the government. See, this is how it works. When the government needs fund, what they do is that they will issue some instrument. Treasury bill is one of them. When the government needs 1 lakh rupees or 1 crore rupees, whatever the amount government needs, they will issue a treasury bill to the market. And whoever is purchasing this treasury bill will give the money to the government. It will be always issued at less than the face value. Okay, that is it. At a discount. It will be issued at a discount generally. If the value of the treasury bill is 1 lakh, then the government will be issuing it for 90,000 or 85,000, whatever. Okay, at the maturity date, the government will have to pay this 1 lakh to the holder of the treasury bill. This is how it works. So whenever government needs fund, they will issue the treasury bills. These bills are issued as a part of public debt operation of GOI. They are issued at a discount and therefore do not carry interest payment obligation. There is no interest issuing at a discount and redeeming at face value. That's how it works. Okay. Then next one is commercial paper. What is commercial paper? Commercial papers are unsecured promissory note issued by the corporate entities. This is it. To raise resources for their short-term needs instead of borrowing from bank. See, whenever the corporate needs funds, they can go to bank. They can get fund from banks and all, or money market instruments, whatever. But in the money market, it is better for them to go for commercial paper. Commercial paper is nothing but a instrument through which they can raise fund from other corporate. If I am a corporate, that means if I am a company, I need some fund, I can ask the other company to give the fund. How? Through issuing the commercial paper. I will issue them commercial paper with a maturity date, and they will give me the fund. After the maturity, I will be returning the fund to them. Okay. Like debentures and all this. Okay. It represents a promise by the borrowing company to repay loan at a specified date. That's it. See, in commercial paper, the parties are corporates, company to company. Okay. In case of treasury bills, the government is issuing, and in case of commercial bills, it is a seller who is drawing and it is accepted by the buyer. When there is a transaction, it happens. And in case of call or notice money, it is banks between them. This is happening. Okay, so every financial instrument have its purpose. Next one is certificate of deposit. CDs. CDs are deposits receipts issued by the bank against the deposit kept by the individuals, companies or PSUs and other institutions. Non-resident Indian can also subscribe to CDs, but only on a repatriation basis. See, what is CD? CD is a guarantee given by the bank. This guarantee can be used instead of money. See, if I have some huge purchase for my company or for myself, I can give the fund now to the company and I can purchase, ready purchase, spot market purchase. But sometimes there are some liquidity issues, you cannot issue the funds and all. But you have a huge deposit in your bank, but you cannot withdraw it now for this transaction purpose. So what you do is that you will say the bank to give a certificate for the deposit that you have in that bank. The bank will give you this certificate of deposit, and this CD you can give to the seller, who will be satisfied with these CDs, and you can give a maturity period in the CD, and until then they will keep these CDs as a document. When you pay the fund, it will be returned. Okay, that is a validity. So instead of giving the money, you can give CD in certain cases. Okay. Next one is interbank term money market. Interbank, it is between banks. Okay. This is a market in which bank alone, both commercial and corporate banks participate. See, both commercial banks and cooperative banks participate in this. They borrow and lend fund from and to each other for a period over 14 days and generally up to 19 days. No collateral security. Rate of interest are market determined. Lender cannot prematurely call back these loans. The instrument is not liquid. See, the difference between interbank term money market and call money or notice money is, call money or notice money is a maturity period from 1 day to 14 days. But if it is a long term, then you cannot go for call money or notice money. You have to go for interbank term money market. In that, you will get a turnover which is over 14 days. More than 14 days will be the maturity and less than 90 days. Okay, so if you are going for long term fund requirement, then you can go for interbank term money. If it is a short term or overnight money requirement, then you can go for call or notice money. Okay, and you can see that in the last word, the instrument is not liquid. Why? Because you cannot redeem it at any time that you need. It is not like call money. Okay, in call money, whenever the bank asks in return their fund, you have to give. Okay, there should be no short notice or call or overnight money. But in case of this market, whatever is the maturity date, on that mature date only you have to pay. Until then, it cannot be withdrawn. That is why lender cannot prematurely call back the loan. Prematurely, before the maturity, the lender cannot ask for the money. So it is not a liquid fund. Okay, understood? Now, collateral loan market. Collateral loan market means, in this market, commercial bank provides loan against the government securities and bonds. Commercial banks is giving loan against the government securities and bonds. When the commercial banks give loan against the government securities and bonds, we call it as collateral loan market. It is also a money market instrument. These are the money market instruments that we have discussed in this chapter. So, next we are going for the defects of the money market. Defects of Indian money market. Let us see what are the defects. Dichotomy between organized and unorganized sector. See, organized sector is controlled by RBI, but unorganized sector is not controlled by RBI. So that there is a big issue when we go for the money market instrument. Unorganized sectors are easily accessible by the people, but they are not controlled by RBI. So there is a possibility of exploitation. So this is not a good sign for a developing country. So that is why uncontrolled organization is existing, unorganized sector is existing in the market. This is a defect for the Indian money market. So let us see, there is a little contract, coordination and cooperation between the two sectors. In such coordination, it is difficult for the Reserve Bank to ensure uniform and effective implementation of monetary policy in both the sector. That's it. RBI cannot control this unorganized sector. So there is a difference between the interest rate, their terms, their conditions, all this is different. So this will make a conflict in the economic scenario. Okay, that is one defect, dichotomy. Next one is predominance of unorganized sector. This is also very important, because since unorganized sector are located in the very minute area or cities which is very easily accessible, like your relatives, your neighbors, somebody is involved in financial market or who is giving loan for interest and all this, you will be going to him easily, okay, because there is less paperwork and all this. So predominance of unorganized sector is there in the economy. This will give a negative effect on the organized sector. That is a problem that we are facing in the Indian monetary market. We are not able to control the unorganized sector, which constitute a large portion of money market. That's it. Money market, its large portion is from the unorganized sector. They seriously restrict the Reserve Bank's control over the money market. Reserve Bank cannot control this money market. It is very hard to identify each and every person who is doing this unorganized sector works. So we are not able, that is why it is very difficult. It gives a defect to the Indian money market. Next one is wasteful competition. See, banks are competing themselves and organized and unorganized sectors are competing themselves. So it is not what is the purpose of money market? To make the liquid position, to enable the lenders and receivers to get the fund. So both organized and unorganized sectors can do this. But if they compete with each other, it will have a negative effect on the economy. That's what it says, wasteful competition. There is no need of competition. Everyone have their space. So they should be working. But unfortunately, it is not the case. Wasteful competition exists not only between the organized and unorganized sector, but also among the members of two sectors. Because within the two sectors are also competing. Like if there is a two banks in a city, two banks competing for the customers. Somebody will give you lower rate interest, and some will give you more turnover, and all this is based. They will be competing. Okay, so this is a wasteful competition. That is what Indian economy is facing. Next one. Absence of all Indian money market. See, all Indian, it is not all Indian money market, all India money market. There is no single integration. There is no single integration. No single integration for all India money market. Indian money market has not been organized into a single all India market. See, if you say that when you compare this stock market is controlled by SEBI and this Bombay stock exchanges. Okay, it is properly controlled. We can control them. But in the case of money market, it is not easy because there are unorganized sectors also and organized sectors also. They cannot form a uniformity. That is also a big defect of Indian economy. Okay, single integration is not possible. This being brings conflict among the instruments of Indian money market. Then adequate banking facility. It is not adequate, inadequate, okay, inadequate banking facility. Even though we say there are many banking branches and all this, but still there are many cities and villages who are not having the banking facility. Okay, Indian money market is inadequate to meet the financial needs of the economy. Vast rural areas still exist without banking facilities. As compared to the size and population of the country, the banking institutions are not enough. See, when we compare with the population and size, it is not enough. Even till it is not enough. Okay. Shortage of capital. This is also a very big issue. The availability of capital in the money market is insufficient to meet the needs of the industry and trade in the country. Most people need fund, but it is not available in the money market. That is also a big issue. Okay. People are converting the fund into some other areas like stock market and business and all this. So in that case, money market is not having proper fund. Okay. Seasonal shortage of fund is also there. Seasonal shortage of fund means sometimes in a year, sometimes we have the huge fund available in the market and sometimes we don't have. So that is also an issue. Sometimes we'll have a seasonal shortage. A major drawback of the Indian money market is the seasonal stringency of credit and higher interest rate during the part of the year. Okay, that is also a big issue. Then diversity of interest rate. Every bank is charging different rates, so there is a diversity disparity in the interest rate. Diversely affects the smooth and effective functioning of the money market. Okay, so see, for these points you don't have to underline. I don't think you have to underline each and every words and all. You just have to understand the main points, like diversity of interest rates, seasonal shortage. This point should be understood, and you can write in your own words whatever is inside. Okay, you can write on your own words. There is no problem. There is nothing technical words appearing in these paragraphs. Okay, so you can do that. Next one is absence of bill market. Even though we say that financial instruments, we say that about the commercial bills, but it is not much available in the Indian money market. Why? Because people are not familiar with these activities. You cannot see that billing system, this bill of exchange system available. We don't see generally in the market. Why? Because people are not familiar. There is an absence of bill market. The bill market in India has not yet been fully developed. The short-term bills form a much smaller proportion of the bank finance in India as compared to that of the advanced countries. When we compare with other countries, this bill market is not adequate. This is there is a very big absence of money market, this commercial bills in the money market. Okay, these are the defects, the 9 defects we have said about the Indian money market. Now we are going for the measures to improve the Indian money market. What are the measures? First one, activities of the indigenous banks should be brought under the effective control of Reserve Bank of India. That's it. Effective control of the Reserve Bank of India is very important. Now we have said that there is many unorganized sectors where there is no control of the RBI, and there is also something loosely linked like cooperative banks in which there is a credit societies and rural urban banking system. This is not working properly with the RBI regulation. So this should be brought in effective control. That is first thing. Then hundis used in the money market should be standardized and written in the uniform manner. See, hundis and all these are written in different forms in different areas. So there is no uniformity, and people don't understand about these Hindis and all this. So there is should be a uniformity. Proper formatting, written format should be there. Next one is, banking facilities should be expanded. More banks should be introduced. That's it. Discounting and rediscounting facility should be expanded. We have said that discounting and rediscounting is related to the bill of exchange. That should be expanded. The number of clearing house in the country should be increased. Clearing house means like when you give the check and all to the bank, they will be clearing. They will be clearing with the 2 days and 3 days. This clearing house is looking after these things. Okay. So in the bank, in the money market also, there should be a clearing house to dispose of the issues in the money market to get more funds. How they will contact this party and who is going to clear these issues within the due dates and all this, whether it is happening or not, it should be checked. So there is a clearing house. There should be a clearing house, and the number of clearing house should be increased in order to evaluate the proper disposal of these loans in the money market. Then next one is, adequate and less costly remittance facility should be provided to the businessman. Adequate and less costly remittance facility. See, less cost, that means low cost finance should be given, and it should be given adequately. Whatever they need, that should be given. Most of the banks gives fund less than what they require mostly. That's why many business projects, their requirement more than what they need, then only they get the actual amount. That's the case of Indian banking system. So this should be avoided, and it should be given at lower cost, then only more people will be investing in the Indian money market. Okay. Next one is, variation in the interest rate should be reduced. See, every instruments have different rates, so it should be reduced, and it should be given in a uniform and proper standardized manner. So with this, we have completed the money market chapter and the subject economics also. So friends, with this we are completing the money economics subject, and you can attend the test series which I will be giving. So keep doing that test series, and I will be evaluating your answer paper, and will be giving you the advice regarding the economics topic. Okay, so thank you friends, thanks for watching.